So in the previous videos, we talked about finding good learning rates. Let's now talk about a slightly more advanced concept, learning rate schedulers. So what is a learning rate scheduler? So learning rate schedulers change, often they decay, the learning rate over time. So here I plotted a typical example of a learning rate scheduler where you can see the epoch number on the x-axis and the learning rate value on the y-axis. And you can see that we are decreasing the learning rate every so many epochs. So what is the point behind using a scheduler to anneal or decay the learning rate over time? So the main goal here is to achieve better convergence, so better accuracy, when we decay the learning rate over time. However, using a learning rate scheduler can be considered as a more advanced concept because we can make a few mistakes if we are not careful. So for example, if we decay the learning rate too slowly, we don't have any advantage because a learning rate that is decayed too slowly is equal to having a constant learning rate. Now, while that's not too bad, we simply don't get any advantage, a worse mistake is to decay the learning rate too fast or too quickly. So if we do that, we will have a learning rate that becomes too small, too fast, and then the training will get stuck. So yeah, when we are using learning rate schedulers, we have to be careful because there are additional tuning parameters involved to make it work well in practice. And this is why I always recommend in practice to start without a learning rate scheduler as a baseline and then add the learning rate scheduler on top of it to see if you make any improvements. So let's now talk about a concrete example of a learning rate scheduler, the step learning rate scheduler here. So the step learning rate scheduler involves two parameters, gamma and the step size. So with gamma, we decay the learning rate, and with step size, we control how often we decay the learning rate. So here's a concrete example using the step scheduler in PyTorch. By setting step size to 10, we will change the learning rate every 10 epochs. And by setting gamma to 0.5, we will multiply the learning rate by 0.5 every 10 epochs. So essentially, we are halving the learning rate every 10 epochs. And here's a plot of how that looks like. So you can see that we are halving the learning rate every 10 epochs here. However, keep in mind that gamma and step size are hyperparameters. Which hyperparameters work well in practice depends on the problem, and we have to try out different values to see what works well on your problem task. So let's see how our learning rate scheduler affects the network training that we have seen earlier. So here I have taken the plots from the video earlier when we talked about the automatic learning rate finding algorithm. As you can see here, the loss plot is pretty noisy, and this is without using a learning rate scheduler. Now, if we apply the learning rate scheduler here on the right-hand side, you can see that the loss becomes much smoother. And in the bottom right, you can also see that the validation set accuracy and training set accuracies improve as well. So yeah, if we use the learning rate scheduler correctly, we can actually improve the performance by quite a lot. So in this video, we talked about the step scheduler, but there are many, many different types of schedulers out there. For example, another popular scheduler is the decay on plateau scheduler, where we only decay the learning rate if the learning gets stuck. Or maybe the most famous type of scheduler is the cosine annealing. And we will actually see how these learning rate schedulers work in the following coding videos. However, before we get to the coding videos, I want to highlight again that learning rate schedulers are an intermediate or advanced concept. My strong recommendation is to start without a scheduler first and then compare the results without and with a scheduler to see if you use the scheduler correctly and see if the scheduler actually helps or makes the performance worse. Okay, so now that we talked about learning rate schedulers, let's see them in action and see how they work with a concrete code example.